guys are here, and those joining us online, we are so glad. We are having an awesome time here with Kids Week. And one of the things that we do every time is we have to start out with the Kids Week stomp. Are you ready? Stand up. Praise team. Adults, come on out. Let's get ready. Here we go.
Running wild in your freedom.
guys did an awesome job singing. So did y'all have fun today? I am so glad. Now listen, I heard today in your Bible study time that we were talking today about what happened to Jesus. And we talked about how Jesus had come to earth for a reason. He came not only to show love to people, to help people, and even heal people, but he came to die on the cross. And I heard today, y'all learned how Jesus died on the cross and he rose again. Well, one of the things, if you remember from yesterday, we learned about a guy, one of Jesus' closest friends. His name was Peter. Now, Jesus had 12 disciples. Peter was one of these disciples, and Peter's the one that walked on the water and took his eyes off Jesus and fell. Well, Peter was known for sometimes doing some stuff and getting into some trouble. Well, listen to what happened to Peter. When Jesus was getting ready to be crucified, Peter was one of Jesus' closest friends. And you know what Peter did? He actually denied knowing Jesus, not once, not twice, but three times. He said, "I don't even know who Jesus is." Well, when Jesus died on the cross and rose again, they saw Jesus, but these same disciples realized something. What are we going to do now? So you know what they did? They went back to what they knew, and they started fishing again.
I've been forgotten, Joe. I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? If you'd been forgotten, Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
Whoa, hey.
Hey.
Who are you?
Hey, how y'all doing? My name is Trapper Bucho. Good to see y'all today.
Whoa. Hold up. Trapper Boudreaux?
Hey, that's my name, Sonny. Don't wear it out.
Okay, yeah. I'm trying not to. But wait. Come here. Listen, I liked your dance and all.
Hey.
But I'm kind of in the middle of telling a lesson. I was about to tell him this story that happened to Peter, who was a fisherman.
I don't know if you noticed it, but I got me a fishing pole right here.
Yeah, I did notice, and I noticed you got a little critter there, too. I noticed that.
That's my breakfast right there.
That's your
is it right there?
Breakfast?
But hey, listen here.
But why are you here, though? Help me, because I got to tell this story.
I'm one of the greatest fishermen ever, but this story right here, this is the greatest fishing story ever told. You see, I done caught all kinds of fishing through my days, but I never caught as many fish as they did in this story right here.
Yeah, I know, and I'm about to tell the story right now, and we're excited about hearing it.
That's why I'm here. You see, since I'm the seasoned fisherman here right here, you just take a seat right there and listen. And what do y'all think if I tell the story today, huh?
All right. Are you sure this is a good idea that he's going to tell? Okay. Trapper Boudreaux.
Yeah, what's up?
You know this story.
Yeah.
And all I'm going to do is sit here.
Yeah, look, you just take a seat right here. Come on, sit down right there, Patrick.
All right. I'll sit here. Remember, you guys asked for this.
Yeah,
okay.
You just sit here. You just rest. You're a little tense. I'm just going to give you a Bayou massage.
Okay, I don't. That's good. No, okay, no massage. Okay, we're good. All right. Hit it, Trapper Boudreaux.
All right. Now, guys, y'all done heard. This story is all about a man named Peter, right? You done heard about Peter. You know what? I take that back. You ain't going to be resting today.
I don't get to rest today. I was really looking forward to that.
I want you to be Peter. You go put that hat on right there just like that. Hey, you looking real good, Pastor Keith.
This is not going to be fun. Okay, so I'm Peter. All right, go ahead.
Now, listen up right here. Y'all listen right here, children. Now, Peter and all his buddies, the disciples, they got out there on a boat. And they was out there in the middle of the bayou and the lake in Galilee. And they was fishing. Now, they don't use no fishing pole like this right here. Woo! They don't use no fishing pole. What they use when they went fishing, they use a big old net, just like this one right here. You see this net right here? They catch all kind of fishing with this thing right here. But you know what they did? They would toss it in the water, and they didn't catch a single fish. They will be fishing all night long and all through the morning. But they did not catch a single fish. But what they did not know was that on the shore was a man named Jesus. And Jesus saw them out there in the water, and he said, "Hey, y'all caught any fish yet?" And they said, "No." And so he said, "Try and net into the water on the other side, and you're going to catch some fish right there." So, Peter, what do you think you're going to do?
"I'm going to throw it on the other side."
I didn't know. You know what happened when they did? They took that net. They went to the other side of the boat. And they threw it on top of them right there. It's just like that. They caught it.
Sorry. Okay.
Look, you want me to tell the story right here? But listen right here. Listen right here, children. This is the best part right here. Because when they did what this man had said, remember, they did not know it was Jesus. When they threw that net into the water, all kinds of fish came on out of there. All that fish came on out of there. Woo! There were fish everywhere. There were fish over here. There were fish right there. There were fish, more fish than they done ever seen in that their lifetime. Woo-hoo! But listen here, right here. That was when Peter, that's you?
That's me. I'm Peter.
Peter, he knew it must have been Jesus that told them to do that right there.
Yes.
So you know what he did? He jumped out of the boat and began swimming on his way all the way to the shore to find Jesus. Woo! 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 Yeah! Woo! And as you can tell, Peter got a little wet.
Yes, I did.
Now, here's the thing. Y'all listen right here. As soon as he got to the shore, Peter saw that it was Jesus. And when he was so excited, Jesus had a whole meal there. They started eating all that there food down there. But then Peter started having a conversation with Jesus. Now, remember, you're Peter right here.
I'm Peter.
I'm going to be pretending to be Jesus right here. Now, of course, Jesus is more handsome than this fella right here, but I'm just going to pretend just for a second, okay? Now, he looked at Peter, and he said, "Peter, do you love me? You love me, right?"
Yes, I love you.
Good. Then here's what I want you to do.
Okay.
I want you
okay.
to feed my sheep.
Feed your sheep.
Now, you may not understand what that mean right there, and I ain't got no sheep. I got some Oreos. So what? I'm just going to pretend that you are a sheep.
Oh, no.
I'm just going to give you some Oreos right there. You're just going to take, isn't that delicious right there? Hey, you want some raccoon on the side of that? You're just going to eat some of that raccoon right there. Here's some of that raccoon. There it is.
Okay, I'm good.
Isn't that tasty? Pretty good, right? But here's the thing. That happened two more times. You see, Jesus, he went over, he said, "Hey, Peter, do you love me?"
"Yes, I love you."
He said, "And I want you to feed my sheep, boy." Woo-hoo-hoo! There's more raccoon there on the side. There you go. And then he did it one more time, a third time.
Oh,
he said,
no.
"Peter, do you love me?"
"Yes, I love you."
"I want you to feed my sheep." You knew this was coming. Don't act surprised.
Oh,
yeah. Hey, you could get a little raccoon on the side right there. Yeah, there, there, right there. Now, you may be wondering, why would Jesus say that three times? And we don't really know. But what we think right here, remember what he said earlier, that Peter denied Jesus three times?
Yeah.
We think it might be because Jesus was trying to tell Peter, no matter what you've done, I love you, and I got a plan for your life. And the same right here, looking right here, children, is it true for all of you?
Wow. Trapper Boudreaux, can y'all give him, say thank you, Trapper Boudreaux?
Oh, thank you.
All right, come here, Trapper Boudreaux. Let me give you one more hug before you go.
Yeah, hey, just watch out for my poison ivy back there.
Oh, poison ivy? Okay, go on. Thank you. Tell him bye. Bye, guys.
Hey, oh, bye, y'all. See you later.
Woo. Oh, my gracious. Well, guys, listen. Here's the thing I want you to know. With our story today, it reminds us of something. The reason Jesus came is for us. And you know what's so awesome? The Bible tells us that all of us have messed up. We've all made mistakes. Romans 3:23 says, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." And what that means is we've all messed up. We've all made mistakes. But here's the good news. That's why God sent Jesus.
And just like he forgave Peter, you know what he does? He forgives all of us. So, guys, I want you to remember something. God loves you. He's got a plan for your life. And if you're willing to trust him and follow him with your whole heart, he'll show you the path he has for you. I'm so glad you guys online decided to tune in. We can't wait to see you tomorrow for day 4.